Who's going to buy the underwear? That's the question of this video. And atheists will say, oh, you Christians, you're so simple and stupid. And you were, you know, you believe in a guy who did tricks and got people to follow him. And now you kind of live in this thing. And sure, okay, and you're hypocrites. Yep. Let's just even say the whole thing was a hoax and people bought into it. And it's been this following for years. But who's going to buy the underwear? Right now at our church, we're buying sets of underwear for a homeless shelter because they don't have clean underwear. Who's going to do that? Like, are atheists going to run out and do this? They're not. And it's so convenient for people who are non-churchgoers to make fun of Christians. And why would you go there? We're buying the underwear. We're doing the things that most people wouldn't do. It's 20 below outside right now. And we have Community of Promise at our church. We have families living in our church for the week, homeless families that are out of the cold, that are in our church. Who else is going to do that? You see agnostics and atheists running up to sign up for this? Fine. God never existed. It's all made up. But who's going to buy the underwear? Not you. And it's so... And then on the Christian end of things, too, you know, love your enemies. People look at you like when you say that, like, well, no one does that. Or never call anyone stupid. What? You know... Well, so I don't think that people pick their stuff from the Bible that believe in it like a smorgasbord, and people that don't believe in it, it's about the same. It's not really that different. The people that wave the book around really haven't read it anyway, so it's not, or, you know, it doesn't seem like it. Who is going to buy the underwear? Who is going to feed these people? Who's going to feed my starving children with people filling boxes? Who's going to house the homeless and make these homeless shelters? Who do you think's running them? It's these churches. It's these organized people to do it. You don't see agnostics and atheists running out to organize like this. No one, if you take church out of this equation and what they're doing for people around the world and even in your communities, what are you going to do? So that's my thing with the whole argument, atheist or not or whatever. Who's going to buy this underwear? It's going to be your typical churchgoer that's going to have a drive in their church, and you're going to get a bunch of people to do it. And that's the only way this happens. There's not an underwear program out there, and it's not a government thing. It's just people who want to help those in need, and it's organized to do it. No God, fair enough, whatever. Just we're buying underwear.